Welcome to clickmyproject.com.
Now we are going to discuss about the product, a novel color image encryption scheme using rectangular transform enhanced stochastic 10 maps. Now we are going to discuss about the abstract for the process. Image encryption has been an attractive research field in recent years. The stochastic-based cryptographic algorithm have suggested some new and efficient way to develop the secure image encryption techniques. This approach proposes a novel image encryption scheme which is based on a stochastic 10 map. Image encryption systems based on such map shows some better performance. Firstly, the stochastic 10 map is modified to generate the stochastic key stream that is more suitable for the image encryption. The performance and security analysis of the proposed this system in image encryption scheme is performed using the well-known ways. The result of the fail-safe analysis are inspiring and is can be concluded that the proposed scheme is efficient and the secure. Hence, this is proven by the many datasets images and as well as the performance of this process is compared by using the PSNR, MSE and the time calculation. By these the parameters we can justify the whether the process is efficient or not. Now we are going to discuss about the flow diagram for the process. First, the input image is taken from the dataset. The dataset is the folder which consists of the several input images. After getting the two input images from the dataset, the image embedding step is carried forward. In this image embedding, we have to just resize the image into an aspect ratios like 300x300. Then we want to embed the two images and then to create an single image, that is a tile image. After creating the image embedder, the key generation is carried forward. In this key generation steps, we have to generate the one key, nothing but like a password. By using that key, we have to encrypt the image by using the encryption algorithm. After the encryption, the encrypted image is stored in a separate folder. This is the overall process done in the sender side. After the sender, we have to go for the receiver side. In the receiver side, we have to enter the key once again. If the key is matched with the previous key we have entered, means the decryption will be done. In this decryption part, we have to decrypt the image and then we have to reconstruct the image. In the reconstruction is nothing but the inversion of the image embedding. After the reconstruction, we have got the two output images, that is the similar to the input image 1 and the input image 2. After getting these two outputs, we have to estimate the performance by using the PSNR, MSE and the time. PSNR is the peak signal to noise ratio, MSE is the mean square error. Then we have to estimate the time for the embedding, encryption, decryption as well as for the reconstruction. After calculating these three parameters, we can justify whether the process is efficient or not. Now we are going to discuss about the initial running procedure for the process. At first, open the MATLAB 2013, then change the current directory. If you want to execute the code, means just right click in the sender underscore rec.m file and select the option run. Now the initial GUI design was opened. In that you have two buttons like a sender and receiver. First of all, click the button sender. Now the GUI design was opened. In that, click the load database images. After clicking this button, the two dataset images are listed out. Select any one image from the dataset 1 and second image from the dataset 2. After the selection of this image, the corresponding image is shown in the axis 1 and the axis 2 with the title input image 1 and the input image 2. Then the resolution of the These two images are shown in below. Now click the button image resize for the two images. Now the image is resized into an aspect ratio like 300x300. Now enter the key and then click the button key. Now the watermarked image, that is the embedded image, is shown in the axis 2. Here the two images embedded and the one image is visible and the other image is invisible. Now click the button encryption. Now the encrypted image is shown in the axis 2 with the title encrypted image. Now the corresponding image is shown in the folder secure. Now I will save the image in the name of secure. Then click the button save. It will take some time. Then we will want to select the side receiver. Now click the button decryption. Then enter the key once again. Now select the image from the database, that is the secure database, and click the button open. Now the decrypted image is shown in the axis 1 with the title decrypted image. After the decryption part, we have to retrieve the two images together. Now the first image is shown in the axis 1. Then the next image, that is the embedded image, is shown in the axis 2. That is the retrieved image. After retrieving these two images, we have to estimate the performance. Now click the button performance. After clicking the button performance, the PSNR MSA and the time calculation are shown in the edit box. That is the PSNR value is nearly 34.3. Then the MSE is nearly 0 point something. Then the time for elapsed time for the encryption and as well as for the decryption is 37.6.
Thanks for watching this video.